taxes, one of the big issues you vote on anytime you step into the voting booth. But for one amendment on the ballot, it also looks at surviving family members of military and first responders and the taxes they pay. Here's exactly what you'll see on your ballot November 6th for proposed amendment number 5. Do you support an amendment to extend eligibility for the following special property tax treatments to property and trust? The special assessment level for property tax valuation, the property tax exemption for property of disabled veteran, and the property tax exemption for the surviving spouse of a person who died while performing their duties as a first responder, active duty member of the military or law enforcement, or fire protection officer. ULM political science professor Joshua Stockley explains this complicated issue.
I'm putting a property in trust because I'm planning to control how this land is utilized after my death and after my control. Currently, even if a property is still in trust, you are still assessed and you still have to pay property taxes. The Fifth Constitutional Amendment is asking voters, should a property placed in a trust fund be exempt from property tax assessments? So should they be exempt from having to pay property taxes while they are in trust?
To see more on this amendment, as well as the other amendments on the ballot, go to our website, arklatexhomepage.com, and click on Local Election HQ under the News tab. For your local election headquarters, I'm Randy Ayala. 3, WVLA, 3, 2, 1. To see more on this amendment, as well as the other amendments on the ballot, go to our website, brproud.com, and click on Local Election Headquarters under the News tab. For your local election headquarters, I'm Randy Ayala. And KLFY, 3, 2, 1. To see more on this amendment, as well as the other amendments on the ballot, go to our website, klfy.com, and click on your local election headquarters under the News tab. For your local election headquarters, I'm Randy Ayala.